Full-size desktops are great for playing the latest AAA games at high frame rates, or if you need the extra muscle for video editing, 3D rendering, or computer-assisted design. But if we're being honest, for most people, a thin and light basic laptop is more than enough these days and comes with the extra benefits of portability and convenience that you simply don't get with a desktop. The real bummer is when you end up having to buy both, a desktop for your gaming or your heavy work, and a laptop for when you're out and about. I mean, why bother having two full CPUs installed on two motherboards when you can only really use one at a time? If only there was a solution where just by plugging one cable into that laptop you already own, you could extend it with a full-size desktop, all the peripherals and expansion you could want, and even a powerful graphics card. I mean, while I'm dreaming, what if wireless charging was simply built right into a desk? Oh wait, it is. And we did all that stuff. And we're gonna show you exactly how it works after this message from our sponsor, Origin. Origin PC builds custom desktops, like this one over here that we were actually using for a video earlier, and laptops with free 24/7 lifetime tech support and high quality components like Samsung's 970 Evo M.2 SSD. Check them out at the link in the video description. So step zero for making your very own one cable desk dock thing is having a compatible laptop. You don't get dual 4K monitors, 10 gig file transfers, and 85 watts of charging through a regular old micro USB port and cable. No, for this to work, you need a laptop with at least one Thunderbolt 3 port, and we would strongly recommend finding one that has a 4x PCI Express lane interface. So Thunderbolt 3 looks like a normal USB Type-C port, except for this little lightning bolt emblem that isn't even always there. So the Thunderbolt 3 port on our 2018 Razer Blade Stealth, for example, is totally unmarked. If you need to double check your device, you can always search for it on the Thunderbolt Technology website. Now for step one, plan your layout. At a minimum, your desktop is going to need a Thunderbolt 3 hub for everything to run through. Luckily for us, CalDigit was kind enough to send us their flagship TS3 Plus, which can provide 85 watts of power. That's enough to charge a MacBook Pro. And it's got enough ports for your peripherals, wired internet, and a 10 gigabit external drive. Oh, also up to two 4K monitors. Now you could just get a device like this and call it a day with no other parts necessary. But to make our setup really special, we wanted to add an external graphics card enclosure so that our desktop not only makes our laptop easier to use with a monitor and peripherals and you know, lots of ports and all that, but also substantially more powerful. So that ended up making things a bit more complicated. For starters, while Thunderbolt 3 does support daisy chaining up to six devices off of a single port, you can't just plug your graphics card into your dock. Unless your eGPU is the first device in the chain, you'll get awful latency at best, and at worst, random crashes or total non-functionality. Okay, so we just switch the order then, right? Laptop to eGPU, eGPU to dock. Oh. So at the time of writing, the odds of your eGPU having two ports on it for daisy chaining are pretty low. The only options we're aware of are the Blackmagic eGPU, which only works with Macs, the Akitio Node Duo, which is designed to hold two cards, but at only half the bandwidth each, and the Akitio Node Pro, which is exactly what we ended up using. It solves our problems, but it has a gotcha. Even though our TS3 Plus hub can deliver 85 watts of power, your laptop only receives power from the device that it is directly connected to. So in our case, that's the Node Pro, whose Thunderbolt 3 ports can only deliver up to 60 watts of power. So machines with higher power demands, like the MacBook Pro, could end up trickle charging. Unfortunately for us, that is not the case for my Blade Stealth 2017. So, our journey continues. Step 2 then, choose a suitable desk. As you can see, our finished desk dock is completely stealthed, meaning that even though it's got integrated wireless charging and a freaking graphics card, you can't see either of those things when you're sitting at the desk. And that is only possible because of the planning that we did back in step 1. So we limited our options to ones with enough cabinet space and thickness to contain all of our devices and our cables with obvious cable management runs for bonus points. This one fit the bill nicely, and we're mostly thrilled with how the finished product looks. But we're gonna stop short of a recommendation here because the desk's build quality is a bit of a disappointment. It's basically IKEA level. It even uses the same dowels and hardware, but it was at least twice what you'd expect to pay at the Blue and Yellow store. And it is full of little oversights like these holes here that aren't even big enough to accommodate the screws that are included with the desk. Now it's time for power tools. Step 3 is to hide the eGPU inside the desk somehow. Our desk arrived before our eGPU did, but the on-paper specs indicated that it was just a bit smaller than the cabinet. That is, as long as the drawers weren't in the way. So we made room by shortening the drawers. This created an empty space at the back of the cabinet while maintaining the original look. And what's really cool is that these drawers can still be used to hold a couple of pens or a single banana. When it actually arrived though, we did find out that once you accounted for cables and drawer rails, there really wasn't enough room for the giant eGPU chassis. Fortunately, we were able to extract the parts that matter and then prop them up on a janky frame made out of scrap wood that did fit inside the hollowed cabinet. One more thing, we learned from our last desk project that cooling is super important. So we used a hole saw to bore a 4-fan breezeway, then used fan splitters to connect our fans to the single fan header that was already on the Node Pro's PCB. Step 3 was installing an invisible wireless charger. Now the original plan here was to simply cut a charging pad sized hole in the top of the desk and then have the exposed pad kind of poking through. But then we remembered, hey, we have a giant CNC router and an Alex. So he programmed a basic design, including a cable channel, and after a couple of test cuts to make sure that this low-quality chipboard didn't just explode on contact with the blade, we were able to carve out a recess for the charging pad to nest into from the bottom, leaving the surface of the desk intact, but as thin as possible to maximize the charging pad's effectiveness. Then we added these classy dots to show you where the heck the thing is. Cool, right? Step 4 was mounting the Thunderbolt 3 hub. So the TS3 Plus has I/O on the front that we wanted to be able to access, so we used Velcro tape on the top to mount it to the underside of the desk. This gives us both a discreet, slick-looking finish and the ability to pull the device off easily instead of contorting our spines in the event that we need to plug something into the back. Step 5, cable management. Our desk did come with cable management holes in the middle, but we added a few more of our own so that we could route all of the cables from the inside of the desk and the cabinet as one low-key umbilical cord behind the table leg. Once you're done then, the only loose cable that you should ever have to interact with is the Thunderbolt 3 cable that you plug into your machine. And this is cool, it can actually go on either side of this divider down here thanks to the hole that we drilled at the back. That means that it doesn't matter which side of your device your Thunderbolt 3 port is on. So that's how we did it, but let me show you guys how it works. So first, I have to configure my laptop to not go to sleep when I close the lid. Now obviously I could have set up the desk so that the laptop goes here and then it just stays open and I could use it as a second monitor or whatever else, but we were going for the cleanest setup. So once it's powered, I can go ahead and close the lid and it's not gonna go to sleep. You can just kind of tuck it in there. Now we give it like somewhere between 5 and 10 seconds and our monitor should come to life. Our peripherals should, come on baby, start working. There we go. And check this out. If I hop over to Device Manager, we might even be able to catch it showing up here. Nope, it's already there. GeForce GTX 1080 Ti. So because this is a quad-core Ultrabook, That means that we are actually in a position where we can play AAA level games on our Ultrabook just with this one cable. So I'm gonna go ahead and fire up Rise of the Tomb Raider. One other really cool thing that I don't actually have set up here is that with some of the other high-speed USB ports on the back of this CalDigit device, you could also do something like have a high-speed either SSD or hard drive that you've got pre-attached and then just like, I don't know, taped to the top or even just hanging out back there, like plugged into something like this. And then what would happen is even if you didn't have a ton of storage on your laptop, you could plug it in and boom, your Steam library with, you know, hundreds of gigabytes of games would automatically be remapped and then accessible to you. That's something that actually already works fairly well. So let's go ahead and continue our game here. So this is Rise of the Tomb Raider running at mostly high. I've got motion blur disabled and a couple of other things that I just kind of prefer. But this is at mostly high details running at 70 to 75 frames per second. And the coolest thing about it is actually something that probably won't be obvious to you guys watching right now, and that's this. So my microphone's right here. It's basically silent. So for peace of mind next time around, I'd probably put an 80 millimeter fan in the back and just have it draw some air across the laptop. But honestly, we left it running for over an hour yesterday in a game, and our CPU never hit above 65 degrees, so it was chilly in our warehouse, but basically, at room temperature, you'd never see above about 75. And then our GPU stayed downright frosty with all those cooling fans circulating air in the cabinet. Honestly, the loudest fan in this thing is the one in the included power supply from the Akitio Node Pro. So to do it again, I'd do the cooling fan and then probably swap out that power supply. Silverstone has some really great options for semi-silent units. They've got like an 800 watt that I think the fan only turns on if you draw over like 200 or 300 watts of power. So something like that would make this whole setup not just stealthy to the eye, but also stealthy to the ear. All right, so now because we kind of have to, let's fire up Fortnite and have a look at what it thinks will be the ideal settings for our system here. 50% off what? Do I have to pay for that? You gotta be kidding me. What is this? So, it has defaulted us to our, I don't know why there's a frame rate limit. But you know what, I'm just gonna do this myself. Motion blur off, no. God, why would anyone want that? All right, not bad. So we're running in the neighborhood of 70 to 80 FPS. I've seen dips down to 55 or 60. Let's go ahead and jump out of the battle bus here. Yep, so around 50 at the lowest as we're falling, so I could probably improve that by dropping a couple things down to medium, but overall, very playable, and remember, this is at 3840 by 1600 resolution running off of a laptop CPU. Super impressed. I mean, I could take his plane, right? Yeah. Whee! Bye, loser. I'm definitely getting a little bit of chop that I wouldn't be expecting. I think there's a little bit more tuning required to get this running as smoothly as I would expect for the FPS that we're getting. We gotta get out of here. We gotta get out of here. Aw, damn. So maybe a couple more things to tweak here. Now that I've seen this fall down once, some kind of reinforcement so it stays in place better. Probably a good idea. Also, using a mouse directly on a desk surface is not something I'd recommend. If we had thought for certain that there was no way we were going to damage the table, what we would have really wanted to do was route out exactly the shape of a mouse pad and then have it recessed in the table. That's something we'd probably want to do on a V2, but I mean, other than that, I'm super proud of the result here. I gave James the task of creating the cleanest setup, bar none, and as far as I'm concerned, mission accomplished. I think the only thing left now is maybe to do like an updated version for our, you know, MacBook user viewers with maybe a couple of the tweaks that we've talked about, but we'll see. Let us know in the comments if you'd like to see a follow-up. And now I want to thank our sponsor for today's video, MassDrop. They collaborated with COS to bring their original 1984 design and update it to make it modern and durable while remaining light. So these are portable on-ear headphones that can be folded up in different configurations to make them compact for easy storage. They use They use oxygen-free copper voice coils for great audio and a warm, smooth experience, and the single-button control lets you skip tracks, make calls, and activate voice commands through the noise-canceling mic. It's backed by Koss's lifetime warranty, and you can join the drop today and grab yourself a pair of these for $37.99 at the link in the video description. So thanks for watching, guys. If you disliked this video, you can hit that button, but if you liked it, hit like, get subscribed, or maybe consider checking out where to buy the stuff we featured at the link in the video description. Also down there is our merch store, which has cool shirts like the one I'm wearing, and our community forum, which you should totally join. And yes, the animation smoothness is way better as soon as I dropped the render resolution down a little bit. I think it was just struggling a bit at like basically 4K.